Hi everyone, we're going to talk about IFR conditions and specifically how low visibility causes IFR conditions. Specifically, we're going to start our discussion talking about the definitions we use, terms that we use when we talk about low visibility. And there are a lot of definitions. We're going to go through these pretty quickly, some a little bit faster than others. Start out with prevailing visibility. Actually, I really don't have to spend too much time on this because you learn this back in METARS. Prevailing visibility, number one, is the visibility that's considered representative. This is the definition that's used when talking about ASOS machines. Of course, ASOS and AWOS machines might measure just visibility at selected location. They're not looking around the airport, so as a result, they just measure what they see. However, if there's augmentation, then a human is helping out the ASOS or AWOS machine, and they use this definition. It's the greatest distance that can be seen through at least half the horizon circle, and that need not be continuous. If the visibility around the airport is variable, you may see sector visibility. Sector visibility is the visibility through a certain sector, typically 45 degrees arc or more of the horizon circle. And it's used when, visibility is lower in one region or higher in one region than the prevailing visibility. Sector visibility is reported when the prevailing visibility is less than 3 miles, and visibility in any one sector is different than the prevailing visibility. There are technical reporting requirements, such as the different categories of visibility and things like that. Don't worry about that. All you need to know is how to read it in the remarks section. Here in this METAR, you see the visibility is 2 miles, but to the southeast, the reporting visibility of 1 1/4 mile. Surface visibility is basically just the visibility that's reported from the usual point of observation, whether it be ASOS, AWOS, or augmented with humans. And ground visibility is basically the prevailing visibility that's reported at the airport by a certified weather observer. And this is the same typically as surface visibility. It's just a slightly different take. Tower visibility, though, is the visibility, once again, the prevailing visibility that's determined from a control tower at airports that also make surface observations. So at certain airports, you'll have the ASOS or AWOS or human making an observation, and when conditions warrant, the tower will also make observations. That happens when the visibility drops below 4 miles. When it drops below 4 miles, both the control tower and the ASOS, AWOS, or human weather observer are making observations, and the lowest one of those two will be put in the main body of the METAR, and the other will be put, the higher one, will be put in the remarks section. This is important, and you should know this, and you should know how to distinguish which is the prevailing visibility. Let's take a look at a few examples. Here are some METARs from Grand Forks on a day when the visibility was going up and down. You could see at the 1253 Zulu observation, the visibility was 1/8 of a mile with fog and vertical visibility of 100 feet. Now, who made that observation? That's the prevailing visibility. If you look at the remarks section, you'll see in the remarks section that the tower visibility is 1/4 mile. So the lower visibility, the 1/8 mile, was measured by either the ASOS or a human that is augmenting. So the surface visibility is the prevailing visibility there. In the observation right after that, a special observation at 1329 Zulu, you see the visibility is 1/4 statute mile with fog. But the remarks section says surface visibility is 1/2 mile. So surface visibility is higher in this case, and the 1/4 mile that's lower, which is considered the prevailing visibility, is measured by the control tower. You'll see this quite frequently at Grand Forks and other airports, and it's pretty important that you know that. That way, when you're flying around, you know that the visibility is variable, and depending upon where you're located, it may be slightly different. Other types of visibility, flight or slant visibility, is the distance that you can see during flight from the cockpit, lighted objects at night or unlighted objects during the day. Here's an example of flight or slant visibility. Here you are coming in on final approach to this airport. You're about over the middle marker, and typically the middle marker is about a half mile from the end of the runway. So it looks like you got at least a half mile to the end of the runway, and then maybe another half mile or maybe 3/4 of a mile. So you know that the visibility is about a mile. This is something that you should practice when you're flying, estimating visibility using known distances. And remember that you may have ground contact before you ever see the end of the runway. Ground contact meaning that you're able to see straight down. If you have an obscuring phenomena such as fog, that's reducing visibility to a half mile. A half mile is about 2,000 and some feet. So you will probably be able to see the ground at a 3-degree angle as you approach the runway, but not see the end of the runway, and that makes for some problems. There are two other definitions that you need to be familiar with, and those are runway visibility value and runway visual range. The words look similar, but they're two different things. Runway visibility value is measured by a transmissometer along the side of a runway near the landing zone. And what it does, it estimates the visibility just based on the transmission of a light and how much light gets scattered as it travels through the atmosphere. And based on that, the distance typically is about 250 meters or feet apart between the transmitter and the receiver. And measuring the scattering of light, it can figure out the visibility. And this is usually measured in statute miles. So this is runway visibility value, or RVV.
We'll discuss runway visual range, or RVR. RVR, much like RVV, is an instrument-derived value that's based on standard calibrations. It uses a transmissometer in the landing zone of the runway. RVR, or runway visual range, actually represents the horizontal distance a pilot can see down the runway from the approach end. So it tries to simulate what a pilot would actually see from the cockpit.
And here is the main difference between RVR and RVV. It's based on the pilot sighting high-intensity runway lights or other things that help make the runway more visible at the end of the runway. So it's different than runway visibility in that it's what a pilot should see, whereas RVV, or runway visibility value, is just the visibility, whereas RVR is how much or how far a pilot can see based on the high intensity lights and also the time of day and other things. So, of course, it's made by a transmissometer at the touchdown point of the runway, measured in hundreds of feet, and can be used in lieu of prevailing visibility, or RVV, for determining landing minimums for an instrument runway. In this case, for the Duluth Airport, you can see that they have, altitudes or decision heights and also runway visibility range values. And that's what the 18 and the 24 are in those approaches. Here's examples of RVR. Remember that these account for the intensity of runway light, the visibility, and also whether it's day or night. You can see things lighted at night a lot farther than you can see during the day. So here's Grand Forks. This is how it looks. It's in the main body of the METAR right after the visibility. In this case, they're reporting for runway 35 left. The first METAR shows that P means greater than, so it's greater than 6,000 feet, whereas in the one below that, you can see it's varying between 2,200 and 5,500 feet. And typically, RVR is greater than RVV. The visibility, of course, is just measured without any consideration to lighting, whereas RVR assumes that things are lighted up and you can see farther, typically at night, objects that are lighted.
Another thing is that RVR is typically greater than the prevailing visibility. I highlighted visibilities in blue in these reports and RVR in red. For example, if you see the last two visibility being reported as 1/8 of a mile, 1/8 of a mile is 660 feet visibility, whereas RVR is being reported somewhere between either 1600 or 2200 feet for one report, or the other one is being reported as 2000 variable to 3000 feet. So usually RVR is greater because it is looking at high intensity runway lights and also all the lighting in the touchdown zone environment. And of course, you can see lighted things a lot farther than you can see unlighted. Also, another thing is that RVR is reported when the prevailing visibility drops below 1 mile.
That's all I have for this lecture. Come back and we'll talk about visibility and the theory behind the scattering of light.